Welcome to the channel. Today we are gonna talk not about one or three or eight, but seven tips to make black and white art that can be used both on illustrations and comics. I hope you like it, and without further ado, let's roll. Tip number one goes for the mask effect. By getting the routine to add a mask on every drawing that you make, you will get the instant benefit of having less trouble to separate the background and the foreground. Even if you don't intend to draw the background in your illustration, for example, a mask can add a lot of interest. And one way to do it is by using brushes. Different kinds of brushes can be a foliage, it can be different shapes, and then you can erase if you are drawing on a white canvas, or you can select the option of transparency that is close to the foreground and background color. By choosing this option, you can erase using every single brush that you have. You can download brushes on other sites and also on the Clip Studio library. You can achieve a lot of different effects and add a lot of impact just with a mask. Tip number two goes for the geometric shapes that you can add on your drawings. Every kind of different shape. It can be a square, a circle, and then you can add a simple mask or lock the transparency. There are different ways to do it. You can actually lock the transparency or create a new layer and clip it to add different effects on the shape. And with a simple layer mask, you can add the same effects that you added earlier, but now with geometric shapes also. To the geometric shape, you can add a gradient or effect brushes like sparkles, stars, water, fire. And to give more attention to the foreground, you can use a contrast color. For example, if your drawing is more darker, you can use a white color to make a border around your character or the object that is in on the foreground, and vice versa. If the drawing is lighter, you can use a darker tone to define the shape of the drawing. Tip number three is about the line wave and contrast. A simple way to do it is by following the traditional way to make it. You can ink the entire drawing without line variation. Then you can add a thicker line on the border, on the outside. And as you go inside, you can make it less thicker. It also depends if the character has different elements like an armor, then you gotta separate. You can make a thicker overall contour. Then for each element, you can make a variation. For example, the thickness of the muscle of the arm can be lighter, but the detail in the armor can be a little more sharper. It all depends on which element are you trying to get more focus. When we're making manga, for example, we usually get more attention to the eyes, attention to the expression, the luminosity on the eyes. So it will require a bolder line. Another example that you can do is by choosing a light source, then make the lines closer to the light, thinner. Sometimes you can also erase the line. If you are intending to add screen tones or gray tones, you can make a layer mask before this step, or you can add a mask for the inking layer, then you can remove it from there. Tip number four goes to the vector inking. The vector inking is something incredible. It helps a lot, and by choosing a vector layer, you can make your inking with your mouse. I have a video talking about this. Actually, I think it is three videos. You can check it out in the channel. But basically, there are some shortcuts that you can do, and you can duplicate tools. For example, the tools that allow you to change the position of each point of the vector. You can also change the thickness. It can be thick, it can be thinner. You can change the corner. It can be more rounded or more pointer. You can add points, you can delete points. There's a lot of things you can do. You can simplify a vector line. And by holding shift, I think that's a great way to do it. You can have less points, then you make a long line, and you will be adding your points to make the contour. You have a lot of control by choosing to make your inking in the vector. There are different tools and you can see which one fits better to your style or to your workflow, the way you are used to deal with vector. You can add point by point, or you can add one point here and another in the future and then add the curves and everything. Or you can use the balloon, the curve balloon, to be more specific, to add the line at the same time that you can add some colors or some gray tones and screen tones and everything. You have control if you're doing a drawing that will be used in different medias. For example, you wanna print it on a paper to make a poster and also to make t-shirts or banners. By having your drawing on a vector, you can rescale without losing the line quality. If you like to use shortcuts, by holding the shift key, you add a point. Holding the control, you can move. By holding the alt key, you can remove a point. And if you hold shift and alt, you switch the corner. For example, if you're doing hair, you can have a round corner to the body of the hair. But when you go to the tip, you can change the corner to get more a edgy style. Tip number 5 goes for the symmetric layer trick. It's something that I learned recently while I was trying to make drawings with a vector. But basically, the symmetric layer, if you don't know what it is, it mimics on both sides a stroke that you do. It's very close to 3D when you only focus on one side and the other side gets mirrored. It's very nice, especially if you are making a character design chart. You can make the character with the symmetric layer, then you can toggle off the snap to special ruler option, because it happens sometimes that the character has, for example, a shoulder plate on the left side, but it doesn't have it on the right. And everything can be added on the symmetric layer. But the symmetrical trick is, when you are making the inking, if you want to preserve the same position that your symmetrical layer is, you can duplicate the layer that has your drawing in the symmetrical layer, then you delete all the information, you just hit the delete key, and there you have. You can add the inking without having the need to reposition the ruler. Sometimes get a little off, but by duplicating, you preserve all the information and all the position to make your drawings. Something very nice to use, try to add to your workflow. It will increase dramatically the speed of your drawings. Tip number 6 goes to the reaction to a big scene. Usually you find this on comics and sometimes on storyboards to movies or animation. And basically is when something awesome happens in the scene, something amazing happens. Usually that adds a lot of dramatization to the scene, to the screenplay that you are reading. Try to add a panel with the expression, like a close to the expression. It can be of the character that did the action, or it can be a reaction of another characters that are around and looking to him. It's like someone goes and punches the table and he brokens everything. Then someone says, "Wow, that guy just broke the table." And he says, "Yeah, I broke the table." You know, something like this. You add a lot of impact on a simple scene. And it doesn't need to be a super action scene. It can be someone trying to turn on the refrigerator and the button doesn't work. And then you can add a panel close to show the frustration on the character face. In the manga, it's very common to add these little details, and they add a lot. If you're trying to make a comic and you have scenes like this, try to add a panel or multiple panels of a reaction to a big scene. And tip number 7, the last for today, looks simple, looks strange. I bet you are not expecting this, but keep everything organized. Layers, they tend to get a little crazy when you are making a drawing with a lot of detail. Try to keep everything organized. Like if you're making a drawing, try to add a layer to the face, a layer to the inking, a layer for the panels, for the mask, layer for the background. With time, you start to blend these things together. For example, you start to make on the same layer that you have the mask, you start to add the gradient or maybe some effects like we show in the tip about the mask effect. But if you are starting in, and actually if you are already doing, try to keep things very organized. A tip for this is choose a color for the layers. You can choose different colors. For example, you can have yellow for your lines, you can have blue for all your tones and masks, or you can add folders and folders with colors as well. It is basic, which means that if you master this step, it's gonna make a lot of difference on the workflow. And that's it for today. I hope you like this video. I hope it somehow can help you to improve in something. I invite you to check it out, my other tutorials that I have on the Clip Studio site. There are a lot of tutorials there from different artists. It's a really good place to learn. And you can check it out, my channel as well, here on the Ricky's Drawer channel. That's it for now. Stay safe. Take care.